You can do anything in After Effects. Almost anything. But if you're looking to improve your work, don't do these. Stop putting motion blur on everything. When I first started, I did this because I thought I should. It took longer to render, so I thought it must be worth it. Now, motion blur absolutely has its place, especially in VFX. If you're compositing elements into live action footage, you should match the motion blur of your footage so it looks like everything was captured with a camera. But animation is traditionally captured one frame at a time with no motion blur, and that's typically a look that a lot of 2D motion graphics are trying to replicate. So generally, leave it off unless you're using it for a specific reason. Stop adding too much stuff. I know, you're excited because you've just learned a new technique, you found some expensive plugins that fell off the back of a truck, and a stock library with loads of cool cell animated assets, but your job is to communicate a message clearly with your scene. Not jam as much as you can into it to show off and make it look expensive and premium, because you'll do the opposite, and your work will end up looking like this. Stop creating unorganized projects. At first, you won't even realize it's happening. You can see all of your elements in the project panel, it's fine. You've only got two comps to keep track of, one more can't hurt. But let your guard down for 1 second, and you've got this. If you're working with others on a project, trust me, no one wants to deal with your mess. And if we're being honest, neither do you. You'll save so much time in the long term by keeping it organized. And if you don't know where to start, download my free project file template. It will help you out. Stop putting everything in one comp. It can be tempting to create multiple scenes in just one composition, especially if you've got transitions or an element that we follow through multiple scenes. But you can easily end up with hundreds of layers, and it will make working in that comp unnecessarily slow and, more importantly, a nightmare to navigate. Sometimes it is necessary, but most of the time you should find or make moments where you can make a seamless transition to a new comp. Like in movies where they make it look like one continuous shot, but there are hidden cuts cleverly placed where we didn't even notice. Stop using plugins as a crutch. Plugins can be a great way to augment your toolkit, to let you do what you want faster and give you some more options, but don't let them take control. I have a problem with a lot of easing plugins for this reason. They just make it a bit too easy to avoid the graph editor and not make any bespoke motion. But if we're letting a tool choose the speed for our motion, what are we needed for? That's the whole show. You're letting someone else take the wheel at that point. You should be pushing your abilities to make creative decisions and execute them well, not just your ability to operate a plugin. I love the plugin Flow for this reason. Even if we use their preset easing, there's a mini graph editor that we can see and edit at all times, so we're not losing that sacred connection between animator and graph editor. Stop eyeballing. There will be many times where you need to animate something in the center of your composition. So make sure it's actually in the center. Don't eyeball it. Even if it's off by just a smidge, that triggers something instinctual, coded deep inside our DNA, that something is off. Luckily for us though, After Effects has an alignment panel. Now the first thing you should do when you open After Effects is make that window visible. Then never let it out of your sight. And if you require further assistance, you can pull out guides and the always lovely proportional grid. Stop puppet pinning everything. Now I'm not denying the puppet pin is a fun tool to use. Some would argue that the original puppet pin was actually the best level in Super Mario 64, but 91% of the time, it just looks janky. Really janky. Stick to using it for subtle motion and you'll be fine. For character animation, building a rig out of individual components will serve you much better. I've got 2 weeks of lessons dedicated to just that in my Master Motion Design course. The student work coming out of the course has been just incredible, so if you're looking to take your motion skills to the next level, it's a great place to do that, if I don't say so myself. Anyway, stop animating the fun stuff first. This is the eat your vegetables first approach. Take time at the beginning to block out all of the important larger motions, like a more detailed animatic. Then animate it in passes with more and more refined motion. Otherwise, you can easily end up with a project that looks like this, where the first few seconds have all the attention that the rest deserve. You'll be able to manage your time and the project better by taking a larger view. Then at the end, treat yourself. And if you want to know what the best plugins are that won't take over your brain like a parasite, you'll want to watch this next video. I'll see you there.